In this video, I am going to talk about factors affecting learning. As you have studied, learning can be defined as a process of bringing relatively permanent changes in the behavior of the learner through the experience or practice. An examination of this definition may reveal that learning process is centered around three domains. The learner whose behavior is changed or modified, the type of experience or training required for modification in the learner's behavior, the men and the material resources needed for providing desired experiences and training. Therefore, the success or failure in the task of learning in terms of introducing desired modification in the behavior of learner will automatically depend on the quality as well as control and management of the factors associated with the above cited main elements. Let us discuss briefly the factors. Factors affecting learning are learner-related factors, teacher-related factors, content-related factors, process-related factors, and environment-related factors. Learner is a key figure in any learning task. He has to learn or bring desired modification in his behavior. How he will learn or what he will achieve through a particular learning excerpt depends heavily on his own characteristics and the ways of learning. Such things or factors associated with this case can be described as follows. 1. Learner's physical and mental health. Learning is greatly affected by learner's physical and mental health maintained by him, particularly at the time of learning. 2. The basic potential of the learners. The result achieved by learners through the process of learning depends heavily upon his basic potential to undergo such learning. The level of aspiration and achievement. Learning is greatly influenced by the level of aspiration and nature of achievement motivation possessed by the learner. How can we expect learner to achieve a thing for which he has no aspiration? Also, too much of aspiration makes it impossible for an individual to achieve this. Goals of life. The philosophy of immediate as well as ultimate goals of one's life affect the process of product of learning, his mood and way of looking towards things, his inclination towards learning a particular subject, and patience and persistence in pursuing his learning despite the heavy odds all depends on his goals and philosophy of life. Readiness and willpower. A learner's readiness and willpower to learn is a great deciding factor of his result in learning. No power on earth can help a learner if he is not ready to learn. Certainly, if he has will to learn a thing, then automatically he will himself find a way for effective learning. Factors associated with the type of learning experiences. If the learner stands at one end of ongoing teaching process as one's pupil, then inevitably it's a teacher who is entrusted to act as the other port for the desired flow of teaching learning activities in the classroom. Let us here briefly summarize the role of such teacher-related factors in teaching learning process. 1. Mastery over the subject matter. A teacher should know the art and skill of teaching so that the students can be able to realize the stipulated teaching learning objectives in a particular teaching learning situation. 2. Personality traits and behaviors of the teachers. As a teacher, as a leader, has to lead his students in the teaching learning process through the magnetic influence and incredible impression left on the minds of the student on the basis of the personality traits and behavior. 3. Level of adjustment and mental health of the teacher. How adjusted a teacher feels in his personal and professional life and the state and level of mental health maintained by the teacher carries much weight in the influence his behavior and effectiveness needed for effective control and management of the teaching learning process. Next is type of discipline and interaction maintained by the teacher. A teacher who is good disciplinarian and believe in providing due interactive roles of his students in teaching learning process brings more positive and better teaching learning outcomes in comparison to the teachers who are not. Content-related factors. In teaching learning process, one thing that is shared most between the learner and the teacher is the content of the subject matter. Desired instructional objective and educational aims can effectively achieve only on the basis of the quality of these contents or learning experience shared during the process of learning and teaching. First, nature of the content or learning experiences. Teaching learning process is influenced by the nature of the content, subject matter or learning experience shared in the process. Whether the nature of the content material or learning experience provided in the teaching learning process is formal or informal, incidental or organized, direct or indirect, provides quite a potent factor influencing the process and product of the teaching learning. Selection of the content or learning experience. Proper attention, time and energy employed for the desired selection of the content or learning experience best situated for the realization of the teaching learning objectives in the particular teaching learning situation always proves decisive in influencing the process and product of the teaching learning. Therefore, it is always advisable to select content material or the learning experience on the basis of the desired principles. Organization of the contents of the learning experience. Selected contents or learning experience need better organization for the effective sharing among the learner and the teacher. A better organization will help more convenient and provide strength to the learner and teacher for better realization of the stipulated teaching learning objectives. Therefore, the method like logical versus psychological, spiral versus concentric, criterion for difficult level should be properly employed for the effective organism for the course of learning experience. Teaching learning output can always be better realized in terms of stipulated teaching learning objectives. If the factors related to the process of teaching learning are better planned, organized and executed in the proper way, such process related factors have been explained as under. 1. Methodology adapted for teaching learning experience. In teaching learning, much depends upon the methods, techniques and approaches employed for the teaching learning of the selected content and learning experience. Let us weigh the truth of this statement from various angles. Linking of the new learning with the past experience. The quality of the result in teaching learning depends much on the abilities of the teacher and the learner to link the present new learning with the past experience of the learners. Past experience helps the learner to assimilate and understand the new timing by providing success as well as commenting forces for the purpose. Correlating the learners in one areas to the other. Correlation facilitates the task of teaching learning as it allows maximum transfer of training or learning from one area to the other. Utilization of maximum number of senses. Senses are said to be the gateways of knowledge and consequently the result in teaching learning are very much influenced by the nature and type of the utilization of one senses for the acquisition of learning experience. Provision of drill work, revision and practice. Review and practice always brings good result in the achievement of students' learning. A learner who makes use of sufficient drill work, practice, revision and review of his learning can be expected to harvest a good yield in terms of its goods retention, reproduction and utilization of the proper time. Selection of suitable learning material. There are sufficient methods and number of good techniques available for teaching and learning of different subjects and areas of experience. The result in teaching learning are always influenced by the nature and quality of the methods and the techniques employed for teaching and learning of a particular subject or content matter or learning experience. In addition to these above factors, there are other sub-factors which influence the learning process. Teaching learning environment and resources are the very important factors that help by the available resources and for bringing the desirable changes in his behavior. How effectively will such changes be introduced in the behavior depends on the much of the quality and management of these resources. The socio-emotional climate available in the institution in shape of teacher-pupil relation is very important for the learning process. Thank you.